तो टॉपिक इज रोटेशनल डायनामिक्स। Whatever is required today, you will only know that part. You don't have to. You have to understand this thing very much. You can get every material from book also. Any book you follow, you can understand everything. You have to understand each and every topic today. I'm not going to prove all the formulas here because this will be wasting the time. I'm just going to tell you how it is happening. What is happening? See, before I start rotational dynamics, we have to start circular motion dynamics. Circular motion dynamics. In circular motion, what happens? For example, this is a circular trajectory. This is the center of the circle, and one object is being moved from a position. Suppose this is the position A to position B. It is moving around this track. Suppose this is the initial position and this is the final position. Then, if it is the initial position, I can say this is the first position vector and this is the second position vector with respect to this reference I have taken as origin. Then you can understand, this AB is what? AB is the linear length it has covered, linear displacement it has covered. This is your linear distance, better to say. Not, it is not a displacement, linear distance. And what is the angular distance? The angle that it has subtended. This angle, this theta is what? Theta is the angular distance. Okay. Now say it has gone from point A to point B within a time t. From A to B, A theke B te jete, the time it has taken, say this time is t. Okay. Achha. Now here what you have to find out, see, this AB is nothing but the arc length, na? This AB is actually what? This AB is nothing but the arc length. And say the radius of the circle is R. Like, can I write down theta, the angular distance here, angular displacement, whatever you say, this is equals to arc by radius. Say this arc length, I'm writing it as delta S. So delta S divided by R. Isn't it? Tell it, this delta S is what? Delta S equals to theta into R. Where this delta is the linear displacement, linear distance you can say, and this is your angular distance. Achha, from here, I can also find out the angular velocity, because in the rotational dynamics, all these things are, we have to find out in terms of angular velocity, angular momentum, then moment of inertia, torque, everything, है ना? तो what is the linear velocity's direction? What is the linear velocity at point A? The linear, you know, the velocity is always directed towards the tangent. In the point B, it is always directed towards the tangent. This velocity, say this is v, linear velocity. तो v here is what? Linear speed. Now question is, what is angular speed? What is the angular speed? Tell me, though. Angular, acha, linear speed, how we defined? Linear displacement divided by time. And this v, how it is defined? This v is defined as linear displacement, how much? Delta S divided by t. Say I'm writing delta t. Better to say delta t. It will be looking better because the time, this is a time interval basically. So better to write delta t. Time we have taken delta t. So delta S by delta t. Similarly, how we can write down the angular speed? So angular speed is written as omega, right? Okay, we are going to use this notation for every time in the rotational dynamics. So this is called omega, and we read it as omega, not w. Okay, don't say this is w. We say, I read this as omega. So the omega will be what? Similarly, this is delta S by delta t. It will be delta theta by delta t. Angular displacement covered divided by time, है ना? Instead of the linear displacement, here it will be angular displacement delta theta divided by delta t. Achha, now one thing you observe, better to write delta theta. I'm writing it as delta theta. Instead of theta, I'm writing delta theta because I'm taking a small portion of the angle. That's why I'm writing delta theta. Achha, tell me now, this delta theta is what now? So this is one of the expression of the omega. Make a note of it because we will be recording these expressions later. Delta theta by delta t. Acha. This delta theta can be written as also delta s by r. Isn't it? Can I write down delta theta as delta s divided by r into delta t? Can I do that? Which is equals to omega. Acha. Now you observe delta s by delta t becomes what? Delta s by delta t is nothing but your v. V. Tale omega becomes just a second. Haan. Tale omega equals to this v delta s by delta t is v divided by r. Tale from there v equals to what? Omega r, which is a very famous equation. It will be recorded later also. This is the relation between your linear speed and the angular speed. Okay, this is the relation between linear speed and angular speed. Okay, linear speed and angular speed. V equals to omega r. Acha, remember in this way, all of you. See, linear equals to angular multiplied by one r term is coming. See here also, in the whenever we have talked about displacement, delta s equals to delta theta into r. Linear displacement equals to angular displacement multiplied by the radius taken. Here v equals to omega r. Linear displacement equals to angular displacement multiplied by the radius taken. See, in all cases, whenever you are going to relate the linear and angular, now in all cases the linear will be expressed as the multiplications of the r times of that case. What you take in the linear case, okay, linear quantity v equals to omega r. This equation will be required later also. Question is, what is the unit of omega? Tell me, anyone. Unit of omega is what?
Radian
per second.
Hello?
Radian.
Yeah, radian per second. Delta theta by delta t. Yeah. Na? Tale, this is radian per second. Angle we measure in radian. Don't say this is degree, okay? Don't measure in degree. This is always measure in radian. Radian per second. This is going to be required. Okay, acha, another, let me tell you another expression that is going to come. You already know this expression, that is called centripetal acceleration and centripetal force. This is also required in the circular motion. You know, whenever any object moves in a circular, if you suppose if you have connected, you have connected one kind of stone and you are rotating with the help of a string, tale this is moving in a circular motion. Like this is moving in a circular motion, and if moment you leave it, it is going to go straight line, in a straight line direction. Like a kind of force is acting towards the center, hai na? Change of here the speed remains constant, but the velocity keeps changing because the direction keeps changing. Like there is a kind of acceleration or kind of force which is acting towards the center. That is why it is moving in a circular track. Like one force is going to be involved over here, that is called centripetal force. Centripetal force. And what is the expression for centripetal force? You know that F equals to F centripetal equals to mv square divided by r. You can write this expression in the format of omega also. You can express v equals to r omega also. So I can write it as m into, instead of v I'm writing omega square r square divided by r. So this is also written as m omega square r. Tale this is the expression of centripetal force. Tale from here centripetal acceleration you can also say omega square r, and this is v square by r. In terms of linear, v square by r. In terms of angular, omega square r. This expression will be also required. Understood? Similarly, whatever, now we are going, circular motion is done. Circular motion, we are not going to talk in details of the circular motion. Now we are going towards the rotational motion. Now we are going to deal with the object, not a single particle. We are going to deal with this entire object. Whenever it is moving, whenever it is rotating, so all particles here, see, this is only the difference between the linear motion and the rotational motion. In the rotational motion, what you require, we distribute the masses. But in linear motion, you only talk about the motion of the center of mass. Remember, force equals to mass into acceleration of the center of mass. That is acceleration of the center of mass. But here, Whenever we discuss the rotational motion, so all particles are playing the role. All individual small mass particles are playing the role, and also about which axis it is rotating, that is also playing a major role. Because on this, because if you change the axis of rotation, then accordingly force, torque changes. The effect of the motion changes. We'll discuss this thing later. Acha. Even now, we are going towards rigid body. See, why I'm saying this rigid body here? Because whenever we'll be dealing with the rotational dynamics, here one assumptions we'll do from first, that is, we are going to take whatever object, those objects will be acting as a rigid body. Rigid body means ki? Do you know what is rigid body? Anybody knows? What is the meaning of the rigid body? Tell me though. Ankita Majumdar, tell me. Rigid body, do you know what is the rigid body? Rigid body means ki? You can try. Whatever you answer you wish to give, you can try. Follow? Yes, Anindo.
Rigid body means dhrida bostu, Bangla.
Dekho, rigid body means bujhtei parcho. Whenever you apply a force on the object will not change its shape. Suppose this is the rigid body.
Deformation
hobe na. No deformation. Here, with application of force, no deformation. See, this is an ideal case. Okay, practically there is no rigid body. If you apply force, some microscopic deformation will be there. Microscopic deformation has to be there, right? Whenever you release the force, whether it is returning back to its own state or not, but initially deformation will be there. But in rigid body, there will be no deformation. Keno hobe na? Tar ekta karon ache. Because hobe na keno? Because this is what you are going to assume. This is our assumption. Remember. Why this is our assumption? Assumption means we take that during rotational dynamics, because whenever a body rotates with the application of force or whatever it is, so if the mass particles distribution continuously changes, if the deformation takes place, what will happen? The distribution of the mass particle will be changing. If suppose this this mobile phone, if I apply some force or if it is rotating, now say because of the rotation the shape of the mobile phone has been changed, so like what will happen? The mass, wherever the mass were distributed earlier, now the masses will be distributed in a different location. So like if the masses are now distributed in a different locations, so like all things will be changed. Our torque will be changed, our value of moment of inertia will be changed, everything, every parameters which you are going to learn right now, everything will change. Because during the rotational dynamics, this small mass particles are playing the major role, and the axis of rotation also plays an important role. Thale, whenever the mass particles are distributed in a different ways, thale, we cannot apply, the mathematics will be very much complicated. That's why our assumption is we always take the rigid body during the rotational dynamics chapter. Okay, acha. Now one thing we are going to learn here. The same equation of motion we are going to learn for a rotational dynamics. So like equation of motion in rotational dynamics. With uniform angular acceleration. Acha, before I start that, we have to know this angular acceleration also. All of you know linear acceleration. Linear acceleration ki chilo? Devasmita, what is linear acceleration? Rate of change of velocity. Hana, acceleration, what do you write? Delta V by delta T. This is what we write. Rate of change of velocity. This is acceleration. Similarly, angular acceleration is also there. We express the angular acceleration by alpha. Remember, instead of A, we are writing it by alpha. Tale, alpha will be what? The rate of change of angular velocity. The rate of change of angular velocity, we write it as delta omega by delta t. I hope you will not forget it. Acha, delta omega by delta t. See, another interesting relationship we can create here. আচ্ছা ডেল্টা ওমেগা মানে কি আবার? ওমেগা মানে তো ভি ইনটু আর, ভি ইনটু আর মানে ডেল্টা ভি ইনটু আর, সরি ভি ডিভাইডেড বাই আর, ভি ইকুয়ালস টু হোয়াট? ভি ইকুয়ালস টু ওমেগা আর, তাহলে ফ্রম দেয়ার ওমেগা ইকুয়ালস টু হোয়াট? ভি ডিভাইডেড বাই আর, উই ক্যান রাইট ইট না? তাহলে ডেল্টা ওমেগা ক্যান বি রিটেন অ্যাজ ডেল্টা ভি ডিভাইডেড বাই আর ডিভাইডেড বাই ডেল্টা টি, তাহলে ইউ ক্যান রাইট ইট অ্যাজ ডেল্টা ভি ডিভাইডেড বাই ডেল্টা টি ইনটু ওয়ান বাই আর, তাহলে ডেল্টা ভি বাই ডেল্টা টি এগেন বিকামস হোয়াট? লিনিয়ার অ্যাক্সেলারেশন, হ্যাঁ না? This is what? A divided by R equals to alpha. See, here also we have created an interesting relationship. A equals to alpha into R. Then linear acceleration is equals to angular acceleration multiplied by the radius concerned. Then I told you about this already. Then whenever you are going to relate the linear and angular, the linear will be expressed as angular multiplied with the radius concerned. Radius, here radius is what? What is the radius? Here radius is the line joining from the axis of rotation to the mass concerned. Radius is basically what? I mean, whenever we have dealt with the circular motion, for example. So this R is what? This point is your axis of rotation. This point is your axis of rotation. So the body is rotating in this path. This R is nothing but the line joining from the axis of rotation to the mass concerned. Now, whenever we deal with a rigid body dynamics instead of a particle dynamics, tale instead of a, suppose now we are going to consider a rigid body, say here, suppose this is our rigid body now, so give me a 3D field, I mean you can draw it like this. For example, this is now a disc kind of material, you can understand. Now say the body is rotating about a axis, say this is the axis, so about this axis it is rotating, okay? So it is rotating like this, tale after some time this body is going to come over here, say. The body is going to come over here whenever it is rotating. I hope you have understood this one, na? Tale, if I take any point, it is rotating like this. It is rotating. I cannot adjust. For example, this one. This is the thing, though. This is the plate, and here this is my axis of rotation. So it is rotating like that. Tale, if I take any of the point here, say I'm taking a point here. Say this point I have taken. Then after some time, this point will be shifted to this point, isn't it? So this point has reached over this point. Then you can understand here also this point has subtended an angular displacement delta theta here. And what is the line joining from the axis of rotation to the point concerned? This is the R we have taken. Then each particle are executing circular motion. Each particles are executing the circular motion, isn't it? So each particles are executing the circular motion here, isn't it? So here A becomes A equals to alpha into R. So linear acceleration equals to angular acceleration multiplied by the R. Okay. Achha, this is your angular acceleration. You have to remember that one. And also the angular acceleration is written as delta omega by delta t, rate of change of angular velocity. This is your angular velocity, hai na? Radian per second. Achha. Now, one by one, we are going to derive it. I hope that all of you can remember the equation of motions for a linear case, linear motion, one dimensional motion you have studied. V equals to u plus at, number 2 was s equals to ut plus half at square, then v square equals to u square plus 2as, all those motion, all those equations, you know. These equations now we are going to prove in rotational dynamics. I'm not going to prove that, I'm just going to tell you how it forms using the calculus, so we can do that. So number 1, first equation, we can write what? Alpha equals to d omega by dt. Can I do that? I'm not writing delta omega by delta t. I'm taking the instantaneous acceleration. Tale limit delta t tends to zero, delta omega by delta t equals to d omega by dt. This is what I'm going to take, d omega by dt. You know that alpha equals to d omega by dt. From here, d omega can be written as alpha into dt, na? Achha. From here, now suppose for example the angular acceleration has been taken place. Now angular acceleration is what? Alpha. Tale, suppose for example the, because of the angular acceleration, it is an uniform angular acceleration. Remember, it is not a non-uniform acceleration, uniform acceleration. Tale, ami dhore nichi initially my angular speed was omega, and then my angular omega zero, and then my angular speed becomes omega. Tale, I need to integrate over that d omega, and what is the limit? Say omega naught to omega is equals to alpha is the uniform angular acceleration, alpha integration over initially time was zero, then time is t dt. Tale finally what my expression what is my expression? This is omega minus omega 0 equals to alpha t. Tale from here, omega equals to what? Omega 0 plus alpha t. Is this looking like v equals to u plus at? Think about the linear dynamics, linear motion dynamics. V equals to u plus at. Hope all of you can remember v was what? In final velocity, u was what? Initial velocity. A is what? Linear acceleration, t is the time taken. Tale here also simultaneously, omega is what? Final angular velocity. Omega 0 is what? Initial angular velocity. Alpha is what? Angular acceleration. T is the time taken. So this is the first equation of motion for the rotational dynamics. Similarly, we will have for second, third also. So second, third, I'm not going to derive. You do not need the derivations. You just need the expression. Acha, let's see. You can tell this using the common sense. I'll not ask the old children. I'll ask Devasmita. Devasmita, tell me though. Tell me the second equation, what it can form. In the linear expression, you know. Linear motion, tell me. Linear, in the linear motion dynamics, what do you say? A is equals to ut plus half at square. Now you relate the expression with the angular case and tell me what will be the equation in the angular motion, rotational motion. Tale instead of a, what will come? Bolo. All of you has to speak. Instead of a, what I have to write?
Theta.
Very good. Theta is angular displacement. Theta. Tale instead of u, what you are going to write down?
Omega naught.
Tale this is going to be omega naught t plus half will be there. Instead of alpha, a will be what?
Alpha
t square. So this is my second equation of motion for the rotational dynamics. Proof kortei paro tumra. Proof how we can do. The way we have proved it in the linear dynamics, linear motion, here also you can prove in this way. No problem. Ami proof dekhachi na. Proof dekhate gele time waste hobe ekhon bekar bekar. Acha third one. Third one is what? V square equals to a square plus 2a. All of you can remember. Similarly, here also we are going to apply that one. So like, tell me, this is going to be, instead of v square, I'm going to write it as omega square equals to omega naught square plus 2 into, tell me?
Alpha into theta.
Vas ho gaya. Third equation of motion. So we need this equation of motions whenever we'll come for some problems. And if the angular acceleration is retardation, angular retardation can also happen. You are going to put all this alpha as minus alpha there. Vas ho gaya. Now you're going to solve one problem.